Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Crockett Cup 2014. Let's get right down to action. Oh, it's a jam-packed crowd here tonight. The lights are up, and we are ready to go. All right, fans, CM Punk is upset. He comes out with the microphone. And, well, here comes Big Sexy Kevin Nash. Big Sexy Kevin Nash says, CM Punk, I told you I had a big surprise for you, and it's me. So, oh, my gosh, Big Sexy Kevin Nash puts himself in the Crockett Cup tournament. But, fans, they begin to fight on the walkway. The fight gets crazy. The fans are going crazy. Their partners come out. They have to separate them. And guess what? They get a double disqualification, so both teams are eliminated from the tournament. Now, Rikishi says he has a surprise partner. Well, oh my gosh, it's the Giant. Yes, taking you back to WCW Monday Nitro, the Giant. He's going to be Rikishi's tag team partner. This has to be awesome. Oh my goodness, but their tag team that they're facing is Batista and Brock Lesnar. This tag team ranks high in the Crockett Cup tournament. And oh, look at this. Brock Lesnar has the Giant up in a suplex. Rikishi is putting the big booty to Batista. Well, Brock Lesnar and Batista would go on to win that match, so they advance on in the Crockett Cup tournament. Meanwhile, Eddie Guerrero and Rey Mysterio Jr. take on the team of John Cena and the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels. HBK and John Cena would go on to win this contest, the team better known as Shawn John. Next up, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. They take on those diabolical men that we know that they are, Luke Harper. And these gentlemen here are getting it on, and it's getting nasty. But Dusty Rhodes and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat would go on to win against Luke Harper and Eric Rowan. Next in the tag team tournament, you would see the Rock and Rude Connection. Ravishing Rick Rude and The Rock would team together, and they would take on the Rockers in round number one and defeat the Rockers triumphantly. Next up, it's the Brothers of Destruction. Kane and The Undertaker, ranked number one. They would go on to beat King Kong Bundy and Randy Savage. Also, two teams that got eliminated were Mark Henry and the man we know as the Ugandan Giant. They would be defeated. The Bushwhackers would be knocked out of the tournament as well. Now, moving on in the Crockett Cup tournament, it would be these two powerful men that the fans have grown to love. That they would face Diamond Dallas Page and the Texas Tornado Kerry Von Erich. But guess what? Diamond Dallas and the Diamond Cutter and the Magnificent Claw of Kerry Von Erich wouldn't be enough for the Shield. The Shield would advance in the Crockett Cup tournament. Now we move on to round number two. Shawn John, HBK, Shawn Michaels, and John Cena would take on in round number two the Brothers of Destruction, and they would go down to this tag team. Also, we would see in round two Brock Lesnar and Batista as they would go up against the Shield. And believe it or not, no matter the offense, the Shield would go down to Batista and Brock Lesnar. Also, the Rock and Rude Connection would defeat the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Also, moving on in round number two, Sting and the Ultimate Warrior would go on to defeat the tag team of Triple H and Randy Orton, who beat the Bushwhackers in round number one. Now we move on to the semifinals. It's getting hot, fans. Now we have the Brothers of Destruction versus the Magnificent Team of Brock Lesnar and Batista. But guess what? The Brothers of Destruction would go on to the finals. Also in the semifinals, you would see Sting and the Ultimate Warrior to face Ravishing Rick Rude and The Rock. But they were no matchup against this tag team, as we would see Sting and the Ultimate Warrior go down in defeat to the Rock and Rude Connection. Before we get to the finals, we move on to the women's title match. We would see the Divas Champion versus the Women's Champion. We would see Brie Bella versus Trish Stratus. Trish Stratus opened up with some awesome chops, and it was a great offensive match. Trish Stratus ruled most of the time. But guess what? She would go down to Brie Bella as Brie Bella hit a leg drop from the top turnbuckle. Moving forward in the tournament, next we go to the cage match. Oh, the Crockett Cup tournament was great, but so were these one-on-one matches. we have Bray Wyatt, who takes on Jake the Snake Roberts in an ultimate dream match of old school versus new school. Bray Wyatt touches the cage and he enters the cage. Jake the Snake Roberts comes down and he has the snake in the bag. And the match starts off. It's an awesome back and forth between these two. And wouldn't you believe it? Bray Wyatt goes to the top of the cage and stands atop tall. The fans up high in the cheap seats get to see the action firsthand. Bray Wyatt comes off the top but misses Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake takes over the offense and begins to ram Bray Wyatt's head into the cage. The cage is getting nasty, folks, but Bray Wyatt, in that crazy-looking move with a busted open head, begins to walk towards Jake Roberts. But he gets up, and then he grabs the referee to distract him, and look at this, it's Luke Harper. Luke Harper's beginning to interfere, but Jake the Snake Roberts, if you can see through the cage, winds up hitting Luke Harper with the DDT. But it was no match, because when Jake turns around, he was hit with a Sister Abigail. And Eric Rowan meets him on the outside after Bray Wyatt defeats Jake Roberts with Sister Abigail. Now, fans, for the World Heavyweight Championship, it's Ric Flair, old school, versus new school, Daniel Bryan. The match was hot and heavy. Daniel Bryan was taking it to the Nature Boy. He was actually working on his legs. Then Bray Wyatt gets tripped up by Sensational Sherry. Sherry gets picked up and hauled back to the locker room by none other than the other Bella twin. Ric Flair takes control. He gets to do his pump in front of Brie Bella. Remember, he said that he had her first. But then Daniel Bryan comes back with the offense and off the top turnbuckle does a body press on Nature Boy Ric Flair. Now the offense continues because Daniel Bryan winds up getting Nature Boy Ric Flair into a pinning situation. Ric Flair has no more of this. He takes it to Daniel Bryan, sweeps his leg, and begins to work on their leg for himself. You know he's setting up for the figure four. But who is this? Wait a minute. That looks like J.J. Dillon. J.J. Dillon has come to ringside, and he's distracted the referee. Meanwhile, Ric Flair grabs a chair and begins to hit Daniel Bryan with it. Now, J.J. Dillon is going after Brie Bella. Ric Flair, meanwhile, after having worked on a leg with the chair, spins Daniel Bryan around for the figure four, and he's feeling good about it. He feels like he's got it, and oh my goodness, Daniel Bryan has to tap out to the Nature Boy Ric Flair, and old school beats new school. Ric Flair defeats Daniel Bryan. Now we move on to the finals of the Crockett Cup tournament. It's the Rock and Rule Connection versus the Brothers of Destruction, and the action is hot and heavy on the outside and on the inside. Moving on, Rick Rude is smart. He has to take out the better of the brothers, if you can even say that, between these two men, because they're both rough and tough. But they take out the Taker long enough for the Rock to hit the People's Elbow on Kane. And 1, 2, 3, the Rock and Rude Connection defeat, yes, the Brothers of Destruction ranked number one. They are the Crockett Cup 2014 winners. My, this has just been a great event. They get the check, $100,000, and the Gold Cup. Fans, this has just been absolutely extraordinary. They are your winners. They take the whole tournament, and this has been the Crockett Cup 2014.